Whoa, lady, relax. Me and my brother, we just want to know if y'all can help us out.
I said back off, Carly.
We don't want any trouble. We don't want any trouble.
Don't want any trouble.
Of course, neither do we. I'm Andy St. John. This here's my brother Dan.
We're here's just my out brother looking for Dan. Gasoline.
Looks like you folks got the motel locked down, which is fine, but if you could spare any gas, well, we'd be much obliged.
Why do you need gas?
Dur,
for
cars.
Our place is protected by an electric fence. Generators provide the electricity.
Our generators run on gas. Look, we own a dairy farm a few miles up the road. If y'all be willing to lower your guns, we can talk about some kind of trade.
How y'all doing on food?
Oh, there's the temptation. This sounds kind of fishy, though. Because, like, who the fuck comes up and, like, asking for the gas, okay, but telling them that they have a farm with a fence and food? It's like ringing the dinner bell for psychos. No deal, we'll just stay here. It's
this one's on you?
Oh, man. I guess a couple of us could go to the dairy and check it out?
We'll bring some gas to your dairy. In exchange, you give us some food to bring back. We'll see how it goes from there.
Sounds fair. A couple gallons should power one of our generators for a while.
Now, you said a couple of us can go, but it just said you decided everyone should go. Yeah, that's... like, that's what I was saying. Like, everyone should go?
With the vegetables we grow, we got plenty of food.
So this is the thing that absolutely boggles my mind about this game. It takes place in Georgia, but the St. Johns are the only fucking people you meet with a southern accent. Everyone else just sounds like, you know, whatever American.
Me as a leader? They'd want me for
a leader. I gotta give the obligatory skepticism on my own part. I mean, after all, I'm basically Switzerland.
Does anyone else know?
Me as a leader? I mean, I'm the only one being controlled by a player character.
It doesn't matter. Larry knows. It doesn't matter.
You've got to let go of that guilt. The Lee I know is a good man.
Clementine knows. She was there when we were talking in the drugstore. Asked me about it.
I gave her the truth.
I couldn't lie to
her. At least, I think I did.
What exactly did happen with the senator?
It was an accident. I don't know. You know what happened.
You know what happened.
I only know.
They haven't gone into actual detail.
Sometimes I wonder if I should talk to the group about it.
You don't have to. Whatever happened before things went to hell doesn't matter anymore.
That's what I've been saying!
I would see it that way.
Maybe you're right. Listen, over the years, I've reported on some pretty messed up shit. I've seen situations like yours 100 times. It doesn't have to make you a bad man.
I really appreciate that.
I mean, So,
rightly,
the basic gist of it is Lee came home and the senator was shtupping his wife.
Motor Inn is my home now. I moved around a bit. I grew up in Macon.
Right here in the heart of Georgia.
Georgia.
That's what I like to hear. Y'all seem pretty settled in at that Motor Inn. Who's running things over there?
I am Lily Kenny. It's a democracy.
We work as a group, all of us looking out for each other.
I hear that. There's so many dumbasses out there fighting each other these days. It's just stupid.
How many people you got over there anyway?
Enough to defend ourselves. Change the subject. Change the subject.
Kid here's our newest arrival, but we're all looking forward to some food.
Oh, you missed a good line.
Well,
if you said enough to defend ourselves, he goes, nobody fucks with us.
We'd love to get you all out to the dairy. Like I said, we got plenty of food, and quite frankly, we could always use an extra helping hand.
In the summers, I used to help out on a goat farm.
Yeah, that's great. Everything helps.
Yeah, sure, whatever, kid. The adults are talking. Yeah, I was going to say, what was that guy's name that Steve Buscemi played in The Big Lebowski?
Yeah, yeah, he does have that kind of like Steve Buscemi look.
No, I was saying more long lines to his character. It's like, shut the fuck up, Donnie.
Bandits? Who?
Those look like the people who raided my camp.
Who are they?
Fuck you. You knew we were hungry. You guys were keeping it all
yourself. There's only two of them.
Oh no, there's
yeah, and you know what? We ate it all. What are you gonna fucking do about it?
Don't worry.
He's gonna shoot you.
But let's just wait this out. Hope they move on.
Fuck you!
Gee, what a surprise.
Fuck
That's not a very good expenditure of ammunition.
Well, granted, I have never met one in person, but every single depiction of bandits I've ever seen don't really paint them as long-term thinkers.
Yeah. That would probably want to be one of the better ideas for not a new villain, but a villain that they could do, a bandit that actually thinks long term. Or at least a villain bandit that thinks long term. There was.
His name was Zaz, and he was fucking awesome in Far Cry 3.
St. John, I haven't played that.
Oh, it's worth checking out.
Y'all can see how he kept this place so safe.
The fence keeps them out?
You betcha. They fry like bugs in a zapper. We're pushing 4,000 volts through that thing with generators and amps.
I'm going to assume that's a lot.
This looks way too fucking good to be true. It's like untouched. This is this is Herschel's farm.
And now we're going to spend the rest of the season here.
Have any accidents?
Ever have any accidents?
Nah.
It's safer here than out there.
This place looks untouched. You never know. Exactly. The world is in ruins.
It's worth
it. It looks too good to be fucking true. That's what it is.
It's going to be just like the show. We're going to spend an entire season here just sitting around yelling at each other and slowly watching Carly and Lily, Lily and fucking Boatmaster Extreme about ready to murder each other.
I think I'm detecting some sarcasm.
Oh! Oh, you think we're going to spend a whole season sitting around here like a TV show?
No.
We're going to sit in the farm and then randomly cut to a redneck going around cutting off zombies' ears in the woods?
Nope. I don't think that's going to happen. Work together, got under control. I've got things under control. Don't let them need to know all that. What you're doing. That place
isn't safe like it is here. Hold on, I thought you said someone else was running things.
Oh, yeah, I thought she was asking.
I said it was a democracy. Well, I didn't say shit about anybody running anything. We'll make sure you're safe. You're putting words in my mouth, Mr. Big Chin. Does offer apply to the rest of us?
Does that offer apply to the rest of us?
We're all incredibly hungry.
These are for y'all. Baked fresh this morning.
Amazing.
Are those biscuits?
Can't get stuff like
some
that
fried anymore. Biscuits.
Without a cow for milk and butter, that's for sure.
That's right. Hopefully Maybelle will make it through this bout of whatever she's got and be with us for a good long while.
Your cow is sick? But she...
We have a vet, but we could bring her here. We can help you folks out.
A vet?
Mark.
Oh, our prayers have been answered.
Maybe our whole group could come for the day.
Well, how about this? Y'all go get your veterinary friend and I'll prepare some dinner. A big feast for all you hungry souls. It'll be nice to have some folks to help out around here again.
Give us the
Fanny,
fucking biscuits.
Why don't you come help me out in the kitchen?
Why don't I
Southern charm later, biscuits now.
Everyone for the trip over here.
Might want to take someone with you. Remember, those roads can be dangerous.
I can handle myself.
Take this. Why don't you go?
Don't
ahead
go
and
alone.
Take,
take this.
Take care of yourself, Lee. See you in a while.
You're taking Ben?
We don't want to watch Ben. Here, you take him.
Mark, Lee. Why don't you take a look
point.
Around? Once you get settled in, I could use some help securing the perimeter.
Is there a problem?
Sometimes the dead get tangled up in the fence before they fry and end up knocking over a post. It'd be a big help if you could walk the perimeter. You can learn a little something about our fence. I'm gonna go top off the generators before they run dry. Come get me when you're ready.
You betcha. This place is incredible.
I just noticed in the background the sun has like beautiful god rays shooting out, like fucking Teletubbies. Cards right,
this might turn out to be a place. I see a fucking baby face. Wanna play this. We should do whatever we can to help out. Let's make sure the place. Yeah, let's make sure this place is safe.
Think about bringing our whole group here to stay. We need to figure out if this place is as safe as they're telling us.
Right.
Because even though the fence is legit, doesn't mean that Harriet Tubman over there, well, not Harriet Tubman, it's white Harriet Tubman over there is fucking trustworthy.
Way to be on point with that one. Way to get a
good look at their defenses. I couldn't think of any, like, white maternal figures that were deceptively, I don't know, I can't think of anything, okay? My brain is fried. Just like this fence. All right, let's talk to you again, because I'm pretty sure you have some wisdoms of not using axe properly.
This fence would be so much better if I randomly pounded it with a fucking axe.
All right, keep me posted.
Like a post? Ha ha ha.
And a St. John.
Let's take a look at the generator.
What's that?
Generator. You guys come along with gas just in time.
That guy just fucking bleeds that, okay? Southern charm.
It's a little tricky, and I don't want to spend half a day trying to fix it again.
What about you?
Hi. Well, I'm glad you guys decided to help us out.
You're welcome.
I noticed back at the motel that...
Now give us the biscuits.
...pretty well armed. Been stockpiling, huh?
How many weapons do you
no
have?
No one fucks with us!
No one fucks with us.
If anyone tries to fuck with us, they'll regret it.
Well, protecting your people is important.
Nobody fucks with us.
In my experience, having that many guns around is when people get dangerous.
You know what else is dangerous? That fucking smirk of yours. Let's go fix the perimeter. Fence ups, the walkers, are you going to be, are we your first guests?
We can't be the first people you've invited up to the dairy.
Well, no, we've made similar deals with other folks.
What happened to them?
Food,
hmm?
Ultimately, they moved on, looking for the people they lost contact with.
Such as? Fence stops the walkers,
An electric fence is enough to keep out walkers?
Walkers? Is that what you call them?
Well, they do walk.
The old one wouldn't have, but Mac, he was our foreman, he figured out how to amp it up with the generators. We used to sit out here some nights and watch the sons of bitches sizzle and pop when they got too close. Closest thing to entertainment these days, I guess.
These generators are enough to power the whole dairy?
We got lots, and we gotta keep trading for fuel as much as we can, but they all work together to do the trick, like us.
You could turn the generator off when it seems safe. I don't know, it Mark seems like a big waste of gas.
Oh, good. The fence will stop a walker in about 3 or 4 seconds, but it's overloaded if we leave the husks out there.
You know, Mark and I can clear the fence ourselves if you want to stay here and finish up with the generators.
You need to turn that thing off, we're going to have to fix anything.
I'll turn off the northwest section, if you guys could strip them off and look for any weak points, well, that'd be a big help.
Sounds easy enough.
Stay attentive. You never know.
So, to bring you up to speed on some of the different choices you've made so far, with saving the guy out in the woods, if you had decided to go for the chain or just taken too long, they would have fucking left, and he would have been eaten by the zombies, and little Mr. My Dad's a Navy SEAL would have grabbed for your gun, get shot in the gut, and he would have been on the back of the pickup truck.
To secure this fence before drawing any conclusions.
I can't wait until
so no matter what, you're bringing back Ben and somebody wounded who will die.
You have to tell him I thought he was a racist? As if tensions weren't high enough.
Sorry, man. It popped out. I mean, you did admit it.
Yeah, right, kind of like when you talked about the veterinarian that we didn't need to let that spill out either. We'll work it out somehow.
We'll work it out somehow.
Well, hopefully he'll calm down once he's out here.
He'll calm down once he starts having a fucking heart attack.
There's one.
Well, when you bring him out here, there'll be certainly a weight off his shoulders.
Ugh. Lee, it's dead.
Well, that's the idea, but is it not going to move? Yeah.
Maybe the St. John boys are using this guy for target practice?
Poor guy.
It looked like one of the dude that got the shotgun to the face, it looked like he had a crossbow.
Yeah.
Take the arrow, damn it.
It's gooey. I don't want to.
Disgusting.
Now we have an arrow.
Who do you think he was?
Israel's not one of us. It doesn't matter. Maybe he's a farmhand.
Maybe a farmhand.
Yeah, the last guy that got to fix this fence.
Long before the fence finished him off.
Yeah.
All right, let's push him off. See? That's smart. Using the axe that doesn't matter if it gets bitten.
I'm sure there's still a few more.
Ew, he was still once juicy before he died. Again.
Oh man, I saw that they put both of the first two Mummy movies up on Netflix. I watched them both back to back yesterday. It was great. Still juicy. It's useless without gas.
Well, it's useless without gas. We might need food, but the St. John's need gas, too.
Not many drivers these days, Lee. We could scrounge up a year's worth of gas, easy. So what's your take on the brothers?
How the fuck do you know?
They seem to have this place tied down pretty well.
They're delaying the inevitable.
Just delaying the inevitable. This place is gonna fall apart, just like everywhere else.
Maybe you're right.
There's another one.
I see it.
Let's do the smart thing and check him. Alright, let's just push him off, I guess, because there ain't nothing better. Cut his hands off.
Looks like a fucking metal album cover now.
There we go.
You never get used to the smell, do you?
They're dead people.
Nope.
Yeah. They probably smell really bad, especially after being deep fried like that.
I can't stop thinking about dinner. Thanks for the rations earlier.
You're welcome.
It's not easy eating in front of the kids, but it's all that's
Yeah, well, I fed them before you, buddy.
I'm hungry too. Focus on the task. Yeah, focus on the task
Just
at hand.
Try to focus on the task.
You got
they
your
knew
food.
What they were doing, teasing us with food and then giving us chores.
Having a good meal will be worth it.
Come on. I think I see where they're getting in. This one must have knocked it over trying to get through. He's tangled up in there pretty good. Come on, help me get this thing back in place so we can get Mr. Crispy off of here.
Think we'd get better
Crispy.
Leverage from the other side.
Good idea. Little help here, Lee?
Let's check that. Check it.
If you're waiting for that guy to help, it ain't gonna happen. Come on.
I'm waiting for it to get up. Now, that he looks pretty crispy.
That's how it always starts out. It's like, oh, he looks like X.
Holy fuck! What just happened?
The fences are on.
Why the hell would he turn the fence on? He knows we're out here.
Oh look, I wonder who shot him.
What the
with an arrow. Okay. Get behind the trackers.
Get
yeah.
Down.
You asshole! Jesus! We had an agreement! Now you're fucked!
Who the fuck is that?
No idea.
Fuck. Now what?
With the fence on, that gate is our only way out!
Ah! Fuck you stone bitches up!
Give a put.
Okay.
Look around.
Aha!
Lee, get back here.
Did you see it?
I didn't.
There are two things.
Stuck in the dirt.
Okay. So on one side, there's a little wedge keeping the wheels in place. On the other, you need to pull a lever.
Oh. Okay.
As we go. Never, come on, do it. No, come on, damn it. Nope.
Oh, I saw it.
Yeah. And it's one of those things, the more you stick out there, the redder it gets, and when it gets full red, you get an arrow to the face.
Yeah, I figured.
Look, if we can reach the gate, we can get through this fence and back to the house.
Ah!
Now you need to be delicate. Give it a light touch. Do a little Jimmy Dam. Do the dance.
Do the dance of the tactor dodge. Uh-oh.
What happened?
Shit. It's one of the dead we pushed down earlier. Gonna have to move it.
Is it?
I already got one of you.
Dude, come on. Push him. Use him as a human shield.
Are you kidding me? Put them on the other side of the fence, Lee.
You assholes.
Come on.
You don't have to go home.
I knew it.
You can't stay here.
I fucking knew it. It's always like that. No. No. Bad zombie.
Put the boots to him, medium style.
Don't lose yourself.
Whoop, get behind the tractor. Are you kidding me? This is fine. Everything is going to plan. Nothing is going wrong. Thanks.
Oh.
Get out of here.
Those bandits are kind of mouthy, but at least they're helpful.
Close the door, damn it. Thanks for not chasing after us.
I mean, we might be bandits, but we're also kind of vampires. We can't come in unless invited. It makes the job a little bit more tricky.
Lee, what's wrong?
It was goddamn ambush. I thought this place was safe. Yeah.
There was a goddamn ambush out there.
Holy shit, are you okay?
He's got an arrow in him. What do you think, genius?
Oh my lord! What happened to you, sweetheart?
Was those bastards?
Look at him. He got shot by an arrow.
I'll be all right once it's out. God damn, it hurts.
Hey,
Mark, you know, give it 15, 20 minutes. They'll refresh the character model and it'll just phase out.
Are you gonna be okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Kachi, you need to get to work.
Pull it out.
Oh, no, honey. Come on. Brenda's got you. Come on inside now. We'll have you all sorted out.
I'll heal you with the power of Southern Comfort.
What kind of shit is this?
We ran into some people on the way up here. Bandits, I guess. I think it was them that attacked us.
They gave us a lot of problems in the beginning. Killed a bunch of our farmhands. We were able to get them to stop by making a deal.
You knew about these people?
Food for protection. Not like we had much of a choice, but they did stop hassling us.
God damn it. Carly said this place was locked down tight.
It was a fluke. It isn't as safe as we thought.
Maybe it isn't as safe here as we thought.
Look, we're sorry. We never had them screw with us like this. Not since we started giving them food. Listen, we may have had an agreement with those people, but we will not stand for this shit.
Ain't no way we're gonna let those sons of bitches get away with this.
You know what are you gonna do? Are? If you were giving them food so they wouldn't kill you, what makes you think you're gonna be able to stop them?
When you're ready to go scope out that bandit camp, come find us.
Bandits? Are you serious? This place isn't safe. We can't stay here.
Not safe? This place is a hell of a lot safer than that motor inn. I think all of us and our guns can handle a couple of punks with bows and arrows. What we need to do is find a way to get our whole group out here to stay. Take this place over if we have to.
Whoa, cool your jets there, Rambo. These are nice people. Let's not do what anything the fuck? To get us thrown out before.
Did he just turn completely into a different person? You took one look at Mama Southern Cover like, I want some of her biscuits.
Well, that's easy. I got charm coming out of my ass.
Yeah, that's real charming, Dad.
Nope, never mind.
Since Carly and Ben ate some of the food on the way to get us, she volunteered to stay behind and watch the motor in until we get back.
I don't trust these fucks.
I remember seeing kids in your group, so I went ahead and fixed that swing while you were out. Hope your kids like swings.
A swing.
Look at
I
his stupid,
swings.
Stupid
just
face.
Like at my treehouse. Come on, Doc.
Why don't you kids go and play on the swing, huh?
So, yeah. You didn't notice it because you didn't go to that side of the screen, but you could have fixed that swing and scored super points with the kids. Oh, well. Oh, well. This will affect your ending. They will remember that it wasn't you that fixed the swing.
Whatever.
Hey, Clem, do you like the swing?
Yeah, it's fun.
Be sure to tell Andy thank you, okay?
I will. Will you push me on it?
Sure.
Sure. Happy to push you on the swing.
Doug, get the fuck off.
Mind if Clementine takes a turn?
All right, Duck. Let Clementine have a try for a bit.
Okay.
You got like four swings. That's all you deserve.
I christen this the Clementine swing. This will be her throne.
We're safe here. I'm not fucking saying that. How are you doing? What do you think of the dairy? How you doing?
How you holding up, Clementine?
I'm okay, I guess. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Hungry as shit.
I'm just a little worried about Mark.
Is Mark going to be okay?
Got lucky out there. Could have been a lot worse.
Are you going to find the people who hurt Mark?
Well, we have to make sure they don't hurt anyone else.
Namely you.
I want you to stay lucky, too.
Ever since I met you, I've had good luck, so don't worry.
Okay.
Oh, we're safe here. What do you think of the dairy?
What do you think of the dairy?
It's pretty. It reminds me of how things used to look before.
Yeah, it does.
Don't worry, Clementine. As long as you're with him, Lee can't get hurt.
I think so, too. Ah, shit, I couldn't hear what she said.
I'm not sure, Clem. I hope so.
I hope so, too.
We're safe here. I'm not fucking saying that to her. That's a lie. That's a fucking straight-faced lie.
Thanks for pushing
it ain't safe here.
Me.
Of course.
We ain't been here for an hour and we've already had an arrow put into one of us.
Okay, Doug, don't pop a gasket.
There's something behind, Clem.
I was wondering to see if I could get in front of the swing.
Oh, it's Kenny. His marker's on his butt. Talk to Kenny's butt. It's the most intelligent part of him.
So why couldn't I talk to him on the other side?
Found anything interesting?
Because the animation has you on this side.
Make sure this place is secure. In case we decide to make this a more long-term solution. Except for those people in the woods. Seems pretty safe.
Good to know. Keep your ears open for anything else that might help us.
Lily doesn't want to be here. Your family made it here okay? How you holding up?
How you holding up?
I hope they feed us, Lee. Soon. On the way over here, I was getting dizzy.
hands shaking, cold sweats. Thought I was gonna pass out.
They've got food here.
Yeah, but I'm not just talking about one meal, you know?
Family made it here okay?
Did Duck and Katja get here okay?
Well, it wasn't easy. Duck didn't look so good on the walk over to this place.
Well, if everything works out...
What was eating him?
Katja can have an easier life here.
That's funny, considering you didn't seem too worried about Duck back at Herschel's farm.
That's in the past.
He's pulling that shit really? On you.
Since then.
Yeah, right.
Lily doesn't want to be here.
I guess Lily isn't too thrilled about being here.
I could give two shits about what Lily wants. Duck and Katja need food, and I'm not about to sit around that motor inn and watch them go hungry. You're with me on this, right?
There you go. I'm not choosing sides. Yeah, I'm not fucking choosing sides. You antagonistic shit.
Think about it, because that time is coming.
I'm gonna go have a look around.
Don't wait too long to help scope out that bandit camp. It'd be a good opportunity to find out a bit more about the St. Johns and their relationship with those bandits or whatever.
Right. I'll see what I can find out.
Can I even talk to Duck?
Yeah. It looks like no, you can look at the swing.
They look happy.
Good to know. You can tell Clementine it's safe here.
Lee, will you push me again?
Maybe later.
Maybe later, okay.
We just gave you a swing.
Okay.
Aww.
Maybe... not saying
I've got some things to take care of. I'll be back in a bit.
Okay.
Okay.
So if you click on the gate or go to the St. John's, you'll advance the story. There are other people you can talk to.
Yeah. I want to get inside that fucking house. I want to see,
The St. John's are in the way.
Okay, well... I don't care. Let me in. There's that instant transmission shit going again.
I should have told you how dangerous it was.
No shit.
You saw what they did to you, buddy. Nobody's safe here until we start to fight back.
But how?
The two of us should go out and do some recon. Then we'll all mount up for some revenge.
Hell yeah, that didn't look creepy.
Who the fuck are these people in the woods?
We don't know. I think some of them used to work at the big box up the way.
Save lots.
Yeah. Anyway, they're nutty as all hell and get mad when they're hungry.
So, are you ready to head out there?
You look like a drug dealer. Not now.
We'll go in a few minutes. Just need to check on a few things before we head out.
Sure, that's.
I don't know if you've noticed this, but when Lee gets angry, he puckers his lower lip, and it's so adorable.
It's like, I'm trying to be intimidating, but I'm a college teacher.
Fence, generator. Yeah, let's take a look at the generator.
That thing keeps a fence electrified.
Thank you, Professor.
Really, they're not going to stop me from going into the barn?
No, you can go in the barn. It's fine.
Nothing got some hay.
Lots of hay. Enough of these might work as adequate cover from arrows, if that becomes a problem.
You're putting Lee in the shame corner. The shame corner if we didn't put anything in the game over here.
Yep. I want to check the sides before I go into the barn.
It's so much goddamn hay! What could they use this for? Do they roll around in it?
Oh, I can go up here.
Oh, fuck. I just noticed Larry is staring straight at that pile of hay like, yeah, I could go for a roll in that. Bring White Aunt Jemima down here. Butter
God,
her biscuits.
Stop!
Old people sex.
My
yeah.
God, I'm so glad you two didn't get killed out there. Do you think Mark will be okay?
Wish I knew, but I think he's in good hands now.
Yeah? It's not too bad?
He'll be fine. I've seen guys go through worse.
How could you all bring us to this place?
How'd you feel about leaving the motor in? About your dad? About your dad? I take it you and Kenny haven't made up.
I take it you and Kenny didn't exactly make up on the way here.
I tried seeing things from his point of view, having a wife and kid and everything, but gambling with your family's life.
Well, you essentially have a kid.
If you ask me.
He's just bigger, meaner, and potentially
hey,
kills
thanks
people.
Thanks for backing me up this morning at the motel. I know I came down on you guys pretty hard, but you do agree with the way I'm running things, right?
Shit. I don't know. Kenny believes, still has hope. You're a good leader.
You're a good leader, Lily. Kenny's too emotional, but his intentions are in the right place. Still, it'd be best for all of us if you two could try to work together once in a while.
That's right, Lee. Oh?
It's a gazebo!
Great. Doesn't offer much in the way of protection, though.
Alright, now I'll go into the barn. Fuck you, Larry.
Larry's just sitting there like,
oh?
Oh, if I'm lucky, what's-his-face won't be the only one penetrated tonight.
God damn it!
We're gonna need to learn how to maintain it if we end up staying here.
Stop with the Larry sex jokes. It's gross. And Larry's an asshole.
Ah, Larry's hoping to get more an asshole than just himself tonight.
For all of us. I guess a few of us could camp out here in shifts.
Go in. Yeah, I've seen the second season. I know that there's probably something in there. Second season, when they had the farm in there and then the what's-her-face came out of the barn, it was like, oh shit, maybe this place isn't the best after all.
Oh yeah, I forgot about the barn in the second season.
Yeah.
Where they're kipping all the Zimbimbis.
Herschel was being naive. These guys are straight up creepy motherfuckers.
Yeah, especially Frog Face there.
Yeah. All right, let's go. Yeah.
It'll be a good opportunity.
Like, Andy there just bleeds Southern charm. Is like, how y'all doing?
I'll stay here and hold down the fort.
You can trust this face? And the brother's like, you can trust my face. I'm like, brother, get behind me. Get behind me, brother. No one can trust that face.
Are you going now?
Yeah. I'll be back soon, Clementine.
Please be lucky.